Birth to a beautiful little bouncing baby boy, and I stopped working my previous job and decided on his first birthday that I wanted to get into something else. And I think eating organic food and knowing where your food comes from is really important. So when thinking about feeding my son, you know, sweet things are important to little kids, and I thought, well, I'm having a hard time around Cincinnati finding alternatives, you know, to take him out to have sweets, to, you know, that's not full of high fructose corn syrup and refined sugar and all sorts of other things. So, you know, what better thing to do to start an organic cupcake shop? I grew up out on the East Coast, and we have a lot of cupcake shops out there, and we had taken a trip out there the Thanksgiving prior to us, you know, jumping into this. Just had such a great vibe, and it just felt like this would be a fun business to start. And so, and then when we found this space, it just all went together. You know, we just knew that it was the right thing to do.
Why Milford?
The thing about Milford, especially old historic Milford here, is it's so quaint and it's just so adorable. At nighttime, they have lights in the trees, and it's just this historic, quaint feel. So when we decided to do this, I saw this corner space, and it just kind of screamed out to me, this is where the bakery should be. And then when we started researching a bit, we found out that this building back in the 1800s originally was a bakery. So it's kind of good karma for the building, I think, that we brought it back to what it used to be.
During Sugar Cupcakery's startup, Krista's sister, Carla, played a very important role.
Yeah, as soon as we get done baking today, we're going to have to start packing everything up. Yeah. And let's hope we don't forget anything. That would be awful.
When I started this, Carla was living in Atlanta. She's a photo stylist, and I called her and said, hey, come on, you know, come up here and help me do this. I know you'll love it, because she's a great baker and she loves baking, and she's got great taste. And I knew I needed someone to help me in that, in those aspects of the business. So she came up and she walked me through like helping to decorate the place and getting it set up. And within doing that, it started to be kind of hers too. You know, she started to really take interest in it. And initially, all she wanted to do was come and help and get back to her life in Atlanta. Well, you know, once you start doing this, and, you know, then we got on a Food Network, you know, things just kind of spiraled, and she was here.
Tell me how the whole Food Network Cupcake Wars came about.
In February, end of February, we got a phone call here at the shop from Food Network, and we were all like, Food Network? That must be the wrong number. Clearly someone messing with us. But as it turned out, it was really the Food Network. We got in touch with them. They told us about the show, that they were pitching a new show about cupcake shops around the country, that they were going to pick 32 of what they considered the best cupcake shops, and wanted to know if we would submit an application, because they'd heard good things about us and really were interested. So we made a quick little video of ourselves. I mean, certainly it was the like last minute sort of thing. We didn't put a whole lot of effort into it. Sent them what they needed, and within a couple of days, they called us and said, you are in. You know, we really love you guys. We love what you're doing, the organic thing, the whole thing. And we were one of 32 that they picked to go out to Los Angeles in March, and we filmed the show. It was such a great experience. We got to meet other people that do the same thing that we do, and do it on a whole different level. I mean, we've only been open 6 months when they approached us and when we went out there. So it was really a big thing for us to be able to promote our business on a national level and kind of show people what we do. So it was really an honor.
Here we go. Cupcake Wars, here we go.
What's happened since the national exposure?
Well, it's been really busy. Our business has really picked up. We've had, you know, in the store and orders, all sorts of things. We're getting ready to start nationwide shipping. Our website, on the day of the first airing of the show, we got over 2,000 hits on our website, and lots of people interested in shipping, specifically not only just our organic cupcakes, but also the vegan and gluten-free and all the other specialty cupcakes. You know, those are harder to come by, and people that have children or family members who have those issues where they can't have traditional baked goods have really shown an interest in us, so we're making that happen.
What do you see, you know, now that you're almost a year into this, and everybody knows, I think, that starting a new business is not always easy.
Is it ever?
But, I mean, what do you see now that you're a year into it? What do you see happening down the road?
Well, I'm not sure. This is really fun having this store and watching it grow and watching, you know, people recognize it and start to know who we are. And you know, we're not a franchise or anything like that. It's a single store that we just started from scratch. I guess if anything, maybe a second location somewhere here in Cincinnati. You know, it's just been going so well here. We're getting such great feedback. People really like what we're doing, and being organic is so important, and it's hard to find around here. We get a lot, our customers come here because we're organic, so having a second location around here, you know, would probably be a great idea. And who knows from there, you know, maybe franchise a bit on the road. I think that our concept is really interesting and unique, you know, organic sweet things. And, you know, another thing is branching off into some other products like making macaroons or some organic ice cream, those sorts of things. So those are all things that are kind of going around in my mind of things we might go to next. It's been really great. I'm enjoying it, and I don't want to bite off more than I can chew. You know, I just want to see this business flourish and do well and just see what happens. I'm not trying to predict what will happen next at this point.
And how does your son, who inspired this endeavor, how does he like your cupcakes?
Oh, he loves them. Every day he looks for a cupcake. Right now he loves the strawberry cupcakes. Mommy, strawberry cupcake. He loves them. He doesn't get to eat too many of them, but every other day maybe he'll have one.